Hey everybody, it's Dave. Welcome back to the channel and welcome to the 2023 movie music tag that was created by my good friend Beth over at Miss 80s Movies and Music. She has collaborated with some fellow YouTubers to come up with 20 questions to get you thinking about movie soundtracks and scores that you may have in your collection. So grab your favorite snacks, kick back, and relax, and let's dive into this. Alright, so these 20 questions were devised by Beth and some YouTubers, Neil from Retro Reels, myself, Cody at H&S Collectibles, Lee at Drum Dumbs, and a few more that I don't personally know myself. But these 20 questions are just to get you thinking about what you have in your collection that's movie related as far as soundtracks and scores go. You don't have to answer every single one of these questions. If you get to a question that you don't have an answer for, you can skip it or you can modify it to make it to where you can show something. For example, if you get to the question about what movie has the best love theme, if you can't think of a movie that has a good love theme, maybe you can show a soundtrack or a score to a rom-com. Just anything to get you thinking about stuff in your collection. So question number one is, how many soundtracks or scores did you purchase in 2022? I purchased quite a bit last year. Might have gone a little overboard. And 85 to 90% of what I purchased were soundtracks and scores. And according to my Discogs account, which I keep up to date fairly regularly, I purchased 65 soundtracks and scores last year. Honey, if you're watching this,
our D-I-V-O-R-C-E becomes final today.
Question two, what is the oldest soundtrack or score in your collection? According to Discogs, The Graduate from 1968 is my oldest soundtrack and or score. Question three, what is the newest soundtrack score that you added to your collection? It can be year-wise or just the newest overall purchase. This is one that I pre-ordered last year. It arrived early this week, and it is Halloween Ends. This is the Sacred Bones release. I did also order another one from Brooklyn Vegan that I haven't received yet with the other artwork, but this is the art version with the red foil Michael Myers mask. On the back you get Michael, or maybe Corey, holding the knife. And in addition to that, I also got the Boy Harsher Burn It Down. They had a track in the movie that was featured, I believe, in the scene when Corey and Allison are on the motorbike. Question four, what is my preferred format to collect and why? I prefer to collect vinyl. I used to collect CDs, and then Apple came along and I was purchasing mostly everything digitally. But then I got turned on to vinyl, and I just really like that vinyl kind of forces you to listen to an album as a whole. I mean, to have to get up and skip tracks is not as easy to do with vinyl. And I just really like being able to take an album, pull out the liner notes, and just kind of read through it as a record plays. So my preferred format is definitely vinyl. Question number five, what is your favorite soundtrack record label? I like lots of the different labels. Mondo, Sacred Bones, Real Gone Music, Vera Sarah Band. But if I'm going based on what I've got the most of in my collection as far as soundtracks and scores go, Waxwork Records is probably the most that I have in my collection. So Waxwork Records is my favorite soundtrack record label. Question six, what is your favorite soundtrack that includes both score music and songs? I pulled Forrest Gump. There's really only one piece that's score, but the rest is all just a great cross-section of just classic American music. Everything from Elvis Presley and CCR through Willie Nelson and Bob Seger and the Silver Bullet Band. Just a great cross-section of classic American rock. So Forrest Gump is my favorite soundtrack that includes both score and music. Question number 7, a soundtrack triple dip. This is one that you own on 3 different formats. It could be CD, vinyl, and cassette. It could be vinyl, cassette, reel to reel, or it could be, you know, CD, vinyl, digital. In my case, it is CD, vinyl, and Blu-ray. And I've got some help from some friends. So guys, take it away.
All right, guys, like we rehearsed from the top, 5, 4, 3, 2.
Okay, welcome to Wayne's World. Pretty on, Garth.
Pretty on, Wayne.
Thank you, Wayne and Garth. Wayne's World is one that I have on vinyl, on CD, somewhere in a box in my garage, and I have it on Blu-ray. I got the Steelbook last year, so Wayne's World is my triple dip.
Dang.
Question number 8, a soundtrack or score from a milestone year. It could be like a birth year, an anniversary, the year you graduated, just whatever, a milestone in your life. And I opted to go with 1995, which is the year that I graduated from high school. That's the year that John Carpenter released Village of the Damned. And this was a gift to me this past year from Beth. This was a Christmas gift. So thank you, Beth. Village of the Damned, the 1995 movie from John Carpenter, which is the same year that I graduated from high school. A favorite soundtrack from your childhood? I'm gonna go with Ghostbusters 2. I like Ghostbusters 1 a lot, but I just remember really liking the Bobby Brown song. I think he had 2 or 3 that were on this, but I used to listen to this quite a bit with my brothers. So Ghostbusters 2 is my favorite childhood soundtrack. Question 10, soundtrack or score with the best opening track. This was a no-brainer for me. I immediately thought of Superman. Those opening credits, so memorable. Superman is my earliest memory of watching a superhero movie. I just love Superman. I love Christopher Reeve as Superman. And yeah, those opening credits, never forget them. Favorite soundtrack score ending credits. I was trying to find my copy of Angels and Demons. I could not find it, but I did pull another one from Hans Zimmer in the same vein as that, and it is Inferno. This is part of the Robert Langdon series of books from Dan Brown. The movies have been directed by Ron Howard and produced by Ron Howard. I really like the end credits to Angels and Demons. There's a variation of that same song, Cavaliers of Sangreal, on this one, and Angels and Demons. That's one of my favorite pieces from Hans Zimmer, so I'm gonna go with Inferno. Best movie love theme. I don't own this soundtrack on vinyl, but I always thought that the Everything I Do It For You from Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves was a great love theme. But for the sake of showing something in this video, I did pull another album that I feel like has a good love theme. And it is City of Angels. Got a couple songs on here. You've got Sarah McLachlan's Angel and the Goo Goo Dolls' Iris. So City of Angels is another one I think that has a good love theme. Your question 13, your favorite soundtrack or score that helps you relax. I wasn't able to find this one either, but I do own it. But I really enjoy listening to the Rush soundtrack or score. It features music from Eric Clapton. It's got a lot of blues music on it, which I really like blues music, and it kind of just helps me relax. It also features the Tears in Heaven song that, okay, that kind of really brought Eric Clapton back into the public's eye. That and the Unplugged special. So Rush is a score that helps me relax. Question 14, a soundtrack that gets you motivated. I'm gonna go with The Matrix. Lots of really upbeat tracks in this one. You got stuff from Marilyn Manson, Ministry, Prodigy, Rob Zombie, Deftones. And I really like that last track on here from Rage Against the Machine called Wake Up. So Matrix really helps me get motivated. Question 15, a favorite TV soundtrack or score, or just your favorite TV theme song. My favorite TV theme song was Knight Rider. Just always liked that opening title sequence and the kind of synth music with the kit driving around in the desert and the red light going across his grill. That's always fun. Question 16, an underrated 1980s soundtrack or score. I don't own this one on vinyl or any other format, if I'm being honest, but I think Giorgio Moroder's American Gigolo is an underrated soundtrack. Again, something very synth-driven, and it's got Debbie Harry, or Blondie, I should say, doing their big hit, Call Me. So, American Gigolo, I think, is an underrated 80s soundtrack score. Question 17, if you had to sell your entire collection and could keep only one album, which would you pick? This one was not an easy one for me. I've pulled one, but I really think there were two or three that I probably could have also chosen. But I'm going to go with this one because it's from my favorite movie of all time. It's The Silence of the Lambs. And I just really love the variant of this one. It looks like the Moss Swing. Just an excellent design altogether. You've got the Death Head Moth on the front in the diamond, which was the shape of the pattern that Buffalo Bill was using to build his skin suit. So if I had to keep only one soundtrack in my collection, it would be The Silence of the Lambs from Howard Shore. Question number 18 is a White Whale, and this is a soundtrack or score that you took forever to get, and I'm going to go with Terrifier. This is one that came out, I want to say in 2016, actually no, it came out in 2017 from the Forever Midnight label. I didn't discover Art the Clown until later. And when I went to see if there was an actual soundtrack or score available, I saw there was one, but it had been like a limited release. I kept watching Discogs, and as soon as one finally popped up and went on sale, I snagged it immediately. So Terrifier is my White Whale. Question 19, a soundtrack or score that you're still on the hunt for. I'm gonna go with Lethal Weapon 3. I really like that score a lot. There's a track on it called Probably Me that features Sting and Eric Clapton. There's also another track called Runaway Train that features Eric Clapton and Elton John. So yeah, been kind of keeping my eye out for that one as well. I know there are some like old like Columbia House editions of the album. It's just I very rarely find one that's in decent shape, so I'm kind of keeping my fingers crossed for that one. And the last question in the tag is not really a question, it's just it's asking us to tag at least one person who loves movies and soundtracks and scores as much as we do. I'm gonna tag Lisa Loves. I don't know that she collects vinyl, but I'd be curious to hear what her answers are. I know she's a big movie lover. I follow Lisa's channel. I'm always interested to see what she's watched that week or that month. She's got some really good insights on some good movies, and I just value her opinion on stuff. So Lisa Loves, if you're watching this, I'd be happy to hear what some of your favorite soundtracks and scores. You don't have to own them, but I would still like to hear what some of your favorite stuff is that's related to soundtracks and scores. That's gonna do it for this video. Again, you don't have to be tagged to take part in this. This is open to anyone that wants to participate. But yeah, I would love to see this get some traction. Beth has a great channel. She always puts together great tags. She puts together great content in general. So I would love to see everyone support Beth. And yeah, that's gonna do it for this video. Hope everyone is doing well. And until next time, take care. Thanks.